My name is Jacques Philippe Piverger, principal investor at AIG Investments. I'm sure you've heard a lot about AIG these days. Don't ask me too many hard questions, please. With that, I'd like to start off by just helping to break down one of the key barriers that I'm sure many people in the audience are thinking about. As you look at the panelists, you look at these people like myself who've done a few things that you haven't done yet because we're a little bit older. But you know, I want to take it back a notch. So I'm from Miami, many Miami folks in here, hopefully. I went to North Miami Senior High, lived in Opa-locka. Definitely lived in some disenfranchised neighborhoods in Florida. And that's, you know, the first level. And from there, you know, I left Florida and went to, you know, a school outside of the state, doesn't matter which one. And it was all about having aspirations and being focused on specific goals. And the question with respect to the state of the Black student, I think fellow classmate really hit it on the nail. It's yourselves, it's ourselves. And there are substantial role models out there that you can look at. I think later on we're gonna move into, you know, speaking about Barack Obama and other folks, and I can point to a conversation I had with a fellow named Jeffrey Holder last month. He's, you know, figuratively and literally a giant in the art world as an actor. He's done many things. And we were having lunch and he was disappointed with the response I gave. And he said, you know, yes, Barack Obama's not president, but guess what? We're always kings. And I think that's what's lacking in the state of the Black student as well as just the state of Black America. And I think now that we have Barack Obama, it's brought it back to the fore, and I challenge each and every one of you to reach inside yourself and realize that power and embrace it. And I think that's where you'll find the answer.
I also wanted to comment on, I guess, the question. My name is Corey Bobby, entertainment lawyer out of New York City. I think for me, for the Black student, for example, that comes to my firm, all right, and they're seeking a job, one of the main things that I look for is what they do outside of school, okay? I think one of the problems necessarily that we as Black Americans may have in this country is that we like to do number one what's comfortable and what's fitting, and a lot of times what we're told to do as far as organizations are concerned. I think we need to reach out and we need to get into causes that not only that affect us but also affect your society as a whole. For example, you know, there's the big green movement these days, all right? I've been a huge green person for years, even before it was popular, all right? When they just started recycling, 20, 30 years ago. And I feel that we have to get out and do other things and join other associations. Number one, it doesn't cost a dime. And number two, we need to volunteer, okay? That is huge. There are tons of organizations here in the city of Tallahassee and in the state of Florida and in some of you all's hometowns where you can easily get involved. So when I'm looking at a resume, I want to see what you're doing outside of the classroom. I want to see what associations you are a part of or a member of that has nothing to do with your school, because that tells me a lot about the person that you are. You may not have the resume, for example, that's you know, one or two pages or two or three pages long, but I see what you're doing as far as your extracurricular activity is concerned, and it shows me the type of drive that you have as a person, and it also gives you an extra notch when you're competing against other people who necessarily aren't involved. So that's just one particular point, and I really wanted to say that just to be specific, because I remember when I was a student, you know, people would always say, okay, you know, there's this great thing that we as Black people need to do. Well, you know what? I want it specific. Okay, you'll come in contact with people you never thought you would come in contact with before, and relationships, as you'll find out in this world, are everything.
You know, I've spent the past few days here at FAMU, and one thing I wanted to say is, if the students at FAMU are any indication of the state of the Black student in general, then I'm feeling just fine. I was very impressed with this group, and you know, I think a lot of times we need to affirm the young people I do believe that you can't be complacent. I believe that because there are white students that don't have internships, I don't believe that we can afford not to have an internship over the summer. And I know what you're saying too about, you know, we can't be too hard on ourselves, but coming from corporate America, I can tell you that I'd like to see more of you involved, and I'd like to see more of you become entrepreneurs and not just stay in corporate America. So how do we get there? Well, we get there from where we're at now. When I look at Sean and the fact that you got 40 internships for different students, African-American students on Wall Street, that to me is an indication that the black students that walked into CNBC, that's how I met you, he brought all of these young men into CNBC representing FAMU and HBCUs in general, that told me that you were so far in advance, you were so far ahead of a lot of the other students. There's a seriousness of the FAMU student, there's an aura, and I think all of you should be proud of that. And when you leave here, you have to make sure that you live up to the high standards that this university has set for you.